Okay. I mean, I'm good.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
Hello, everyone. This is Sean Talese, A Tale of Two Sisters. Quite a long load. So right there, we just skipped everything in the prologue. Long story short, two sisters that were blood-related went out during a full moon, and now the elder of the two sisters is turned into a fairy. So our whole adventure is to cure this curse and figure out the backstory about why the heck people turn into fairies. Now, the game says we're bad at the video game, so it's gonna make us do a tutorial. A little button mashing here, hopefully. Okay, good. These slimes can spawn outside of a circle, and then it's actually impossible to finish the tutorial if that happens. So those are the basic controls, the moving and the hacking and slashing, and now the game is giving us a tutorial on how to use magic. And we can charge up magic to use more powerful spells. And our magic is on the bottom left hand corner of the screen, so there's no mana bar. We use gems in order to cast magic, and it's just saying that, okay, that's unfortunate. Had to use a gem there. Alright, so the game finally says, hey, look, we can move around and do things now. But, we're not gonna follow what the tutorial tells us to do. It kind of expects us to run around and search for things and kill these completely 100% harmless green slimes, but for whatever reason, we're gonna murder them. Because we're jerks. See, completely harmless. They haven't even attacked yet. And in fact, they don't even have an attack box. So if you notice, I'm kind of hitting trees and cutting grass, and it's not, and it's entirely intended as, oh dear, that's unfortunate. I fat-fingered the magic button. We're gonna need to get another gem. Come on. Hey, this is embarrassing. Alright, back into the game. So, there's four elements in this game. Please. Right, that's why I needed the two green gems, because these guys have magic resistance and physical resistance, and the only way to deal damage to them is to use Blitz. That does direct HP removal. And we can hit the trees for earth crystals, and we can cut grass for green crystals or green gems. Red gems come from torches, and blue gems come from barrels. They're all elemented, so it's fire, water, earth, and wind. We finally meet the lady that we saved. Turns out she's the shopkeeper, and we're gonna talk to her quite often. Right, so I got the hidden treasure from the previous map. I didn't speak to NPCs. This is going well. So this shopkeeper tells us everything we need to know, kind of like what the city is like or this town, and tells us to speak to the fortune teller across this town. And well, she's not there, so we got to go and figure out where the heck she went off to. And she turned out that she went here, into the Terran Ruins. Now, unlike many of the other games, other RPGs you've probably played or watched, we're required to defeat every enemy in order to remove the yellow barrier at the end. And it gets pretty tedious when things decide to just not cooperate. These enemies do have spawn circles, so they don't spawn until you get close enough to them. But when they decide to attack is pretty random. So this Terran Ruins, as the name implies, Terran being Earth, means that this is an Earth-elemented dungeon. And we're going to be using this Earth-element-based dungeon on an Earth-element boss, in some cases if we need to. But Earth and Wind are opposing elements, so we'll be using that to our advantage. The fastest form of movement is dashing in the game, but we don't want to dash all the time, as dashing gives you a set distance for travel. And we have no ability to cancel this or change an input or anything of that sort. So we're kind of dedicated in what we do. And that RNG didn't drop any of the gems. Okay, that's fine. We can do a little barrier skip, a barrier animation skip, by defeating the last enemy on the same frame that we approach the yellow barrier. This skips a 1 second animation, and we'll be trying to do that as many times as possible. It happens quite often early, but as the game goes on, it becomes progressively more difficult as positions aren't favorable to us. Did I forget something? What in the... Okay, this is just... This is embarrassing. Yeah, this game's pretty cute. It's a fun game. I don't recommend playing it though. It gets pretty tough at times. So those are some iBats. Those are the first time we meet them. These iBats, they're infamous for being... these iBats are very infamous for dealing a large amount of damage in a short amount of time. This game does not give you iframes, so if you get hit, you take a lot of damage, and those iBats have delayed attacks that linger for a very long time. Also, they deal magic damage, and the two types of damage that you can deal is physical, so with the sword that Elise is holding, or magical, which comes from the gems and the magic that gets casted from Shantae the Fairy. Right, so we've got the best item in the game, and you can't have a speedrun without speed boots. Now things get very interesting because we're moving 50% faster. Also gonna get 50% more. Right, that's normal. Wanna hope I get a green gem? Right, let's see if I can get this multi-kill off the side here. So wait for that slime to jump. Ah, I released it too early. That still cleared most of them. Got some health for safety. So, for those of you who have played this game and thought this dungeon was pretty difficult, there is a nice item that they give you right here. We call it the Barrel Chicken. Ah, I didn't get a lot of money. That's okay. So this is the room just before the boss. We're gonna go and meet this friendly fortune teller. So this is our fortune teller, Elma, and we're here to ask her some questions, but before we do that, she's really gonna mess our day up. Alright, so everyone say hi to the Terran Golem. And yeah, that's how we deal with it. We use the Earth Gem, Wind Gem as our base, and we give it a support gem, the red support gem that gives it additional damage. I'm gonna quickly speak to Ira again, get some more health. Alright, So after a bit of complaining on Alma, she tells us to go off to the Ignin ruins to figure out what's going on and give us a little bit of a backstory on to why we turn into, or why Elise turned into, is a sword-wielding magician with a fairy companion. But once again, we're cutting grass. This game introduces us to bees and beehives. These bees will infinitely spawn until you destroy the hives, so that's why I ran past them to deal with that hive first. We're getting the hidden treasure on this stage. Oh, crits. We don't want crits. They eat your frames. So we want to destroy the beehives before they can do anything. We are after the hidden treasure on this stage for safety measures. Things can get out of hand real fast. 60 health is not a lot to work with. In fact, 100 health is also not a lot to work with. So there will be times I'm going to slow down just because damage has been dealt. And we need to see, just like that, 8 health is gone. Oh. Cut the grass, please. The wall ate my gem? Yeah, the wall ate my gem. Alright, this is unfortunate. It didn't give me a red gem, so we're gonna have to take our time. Yes, the water slash spell chased the bee that we call the troll bee, as it's on the log and it flies off once the moment it spawns. Alright, we got an early chest grab, but ran into the chest. That's a shame. Yes, the volcanic crab can be a handful. It's... The game doesn't exactly tell you that the bosses have weaknesses or of any kind, so I can see why a lot of people struggle with this game. And we're running up a spiral mountain with boulders. As to how these boulders are falling and why they're generally around it, I'm not sure. Super armor, pop that, jump off this ledge to get the hidden treasure, almost fell off, set ourselves up to hit the chest and this barrel at the same time to grab the water gem. A thing about menuing, we finally have enough items that the quick menu is noticeable. What we're doing with the controller inputs is that we're holding down or up and then inputting a diagonal command, which is also registered as an up or a down. This makes it so that we can input multiple down commands to get the items we want all the way at the bottom of the menu. And we can probably get around 20 inputs a second if we needed to. Mushrooms. Yes, the water spell is Splash, and it homes on to the target, the nearest target, unless you lock on to an enemy. So, cases might have been that you casted it, and then you locked onto something, and it tried to chase over to the new target. So that may have been why it just kind of, you know, just doesn't really hit anything. Okay, this is bad. We're gonna reset them. Attack, please. There we go. That's what I was afraid of. Alright, the Ring of Mushrooms. Yep. This will be fun. So we're gonna walk close to this hole ledge, and we're gonna let this bomb behind us explode as it falls into the pit and kills itself. Thank you. this game introduces us to bombs here, and the next stage and tells us, yeah, we should probably stop hitting them. Probably. When the bombs are defeated, they explode. The explosions do physical damage, and it hurts quite a bit. So we're gonna do our very best to use magic and stay ranged in order to prevent taking additional damage. Okay, 53 health going in here. We can work with that. Okay. Just gonna take it slow here. They can very easily knock you off into the hole for 3 damage, or into the lava for 3 damage, because that counts as falling off the stage. And those iPads can easily deal 22 damage, and only having 60 health is, that means we can only take 3, can only take 2 hits before dying. Right, so here's a mechanic that the game never tells you. You can hold the magic button in order to drop gems, and this allows you to preserve the gems for later use and rearrange their gem order. Oh, I never spoke about gem orders. The first gem you pick up is actually the last gem you consume. So there is a reasonable amount of gem management involved. Everything in this game is cute. Okay, what do we got to work with? Blue gems? Good. Don't want to run into that. Okay, I'm gonna wait a cycle here. Okay. Bomb, I don't want to destroy you yet. Unfortunately, they didn't drop any sort of magic to deal with the skeletons, so I'm gonna have to use these gems now. Yay, runs off the edge. You. 1, 2, 3. Nothing to work with. Alright, we're gonna intentionally take the damage from this giant bomb, because all giant bombs are guaranteed to drop big toast. Yeah, so some part of them is edible, and I guess it would make sense that they toast their own bread. Sorry. This game finally decides to be a jerk and introduce knights. They are completely immune to magic and block all incoming damage from the front. But we're just gonna cheese them and hit them from behind while standing in the front. We'll get to see more of them later, and they are, they have high amounts of health and are very time consuming to deal with. There he is. I was wondering where this ghost went. Come on. These ghosts go invisible when you hit them, or they shoot up into the sky and then turn invulnerable. And I guess you could say translucent. Nah, just like that. You see them, it's hard to see sometimes, but they're there. And they like to float around in front of you. Nope, no gems. Spawn those skeletons before we do anything. Wait, these guys? Okay, we can work with this. Okay. My computer is doing something. Thank you. The Wraith ate my that ghost ate the fire gem. So the green support gem gives you a triple shot, or it adds two projectiles onto your account. And now we're gonna go off and get the hidden treasure in this area. So I went up. I intentionally went up the crits again. So I intentionally went up the west stairs because this hidden treasure requires us to go up in a full lap on this upper section without stopping. And the game defines not stopping as holding the up direction the entire time, or the forward direction the entire time. And we've got ourselves some winged boots. We won't be using them immediately, but they are required to save time later. And they're just fun to have. Did I get him? Yes! Okay, so we're going into the boss of this dungeon, Mr. Volcanic Crab. There's a tapestry on the wall. It says some sort of sword-wielding human and a fairy fighting some giant creature. Yeah, I don't know what's going on either. Hi, Volcanic Crab. So this boss, you need to flip him over by knocking him into these pits. Alright, now is a good time to. So you flip him over and he takes full damage. And the Ignin Ruins. So the Ignin Ruins is weak to water. And we're just using a ton of blue gems here. That's unfortunate. One, two, three. Alright, there you go. Thank you for wishing me good luck. And I hope everyone here is enjoying the marathon. So that's the Ignin Ruins dealt with. We're off to Chapter 3, the Blue Rose. Okay, this is when the story gets really complicated, and so Elise passed out at the end of the the end of that ruin or dungeon, and the story goes is that she has her energy, her health is being drained because fairy dust has some weird side effects. Don't do drugs, kids. And now, we have Elma deciding to help find this non-existent blue rose in the Aquan Ruins. And for whatever reason, we're playing exactly like Elise. As for why we're not just using magic, because I mean, Elma clearly has the ability to summon a golem, I don't see why we just don't use that to begin with. But yeah, we're here in this Aquan Ruins. There we go. So these fish are quite the handful. Even though I'm wearing the shield that prevents physical damage, they can very easily deal 10 hit points per hit. And this game doesn't have iframes. And fish don't spawn alone. So you can very easily take large amounts of damage in a short amount of time. Ooh, 20 health right there gone. Spawn these fish. Spawn these ones. So after defeating the... Okay, well that fish didn't want me to have that. So after defeating the Volcanic Crab, we were given the ability to cast 3 gems instead of 2. And we're going to be using this tornado skill, this tornado magic, a lot. as it groups enemies up nicely for us. Please attack. There we go. Yep, cutting more grass in order to get our green gems. Ow. But I did not want to pick that up, but we're just gonna go with it. 1, 2, 3, 4. So for those of you who are observant, you may have noticed that I was jumping a lot when I was in water. That's because water reduces your movement speed by half, and when we jump, the game doesn't register we're in water. Hey, I'm sorry you bought this game. I mean, yay, you bought this game. Ah, come on, please, there we go. Alright, so we're having fun stabbing these knights in the back. And for those of you who are Dark Souls fans, we call it dead angling. Yep. Generally we're standing in front of this, its shield, facing the same direction the enemy is, and then it can't stop us. There's nothing wrong with this. Nope, I don't see anything wrong with this. Okay, let's collect our red gems. So, jumping off the bridge resets our camera, and we're gonna need these gems. And we need this camera to reset for two reasons. First off, jumping off the edge spawns us back at the beginning of the stage. Secondly, it resets the camera to make this part really easy. And the hidden treasure here is to just walk across this ledge, which we're clearly walking across, in order to get the fire crystal. Now, you don't want to hold the skip text button before entering the area, because it will cue magic, and when we immediately spawn or we load up our characters, we'll use the magic right away. So we want to wait till the text box appears before skipping all that text. And now we're in the spiral corridor. We're having fun dashing past all these enemies. Right now, These guys, they really want our heads. So they're gonna try and jump at us. Straight off into the center of the stage. Filled with water, which is a death plane. I'm gonna run into this barrier and skip the animation of this thing disappearing. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so what in the world just happened? We went across the bridge into a spiral corridor. We went up, by the way, and now we're underwater. So anyone can explain what in the world is going on, be my guest. Jellyfish. Aww. So jellyfish, they just float around and always have their attack hitbox active. They don't move very far, but they hit very hard. Okay, this is unfortunate. No good gem drops. So we're gonna have to farm some gems off these skeletons. Nope. They did not want me to have that gem. So, this is the room right before the boss, and hopefully I can get the quick kill on this. It has been unsuccessful twice during practice. But we'll see. I didn't count how many gems. Okay, we're good. Just for safety measure. This game is quite entertaining to speedrun. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3. Right, we're gonna use 3, 6 fire gems, firewall, and it just kinda melts. And if anyone can also explain how fire is lit underwater, be my guest. Oh hey look, we found the non-existent blue rose. That I don't know what they do with the blue rose, but it cures at least. Alright, sell the music box, buy the white gauntlet, and as much health as we can carry. Ignore that alarm. We're gonna unequip the gloves for a little bit. Now, the note on Elma's door says that she's in the Zephyrin Ruins, so I guess we're following her. Now, I took the gloves off to deal less damage, as every time you deal an attack, a physical attack, it has a chance of dropping gems. And we're gonna see if we can get as many gems as possible. Hopefully. The ones that we want. Because we're in the Zephyrin Ruins, so the dungeon doesn't want us to get green gems, as it would be technically a disadvantage. But no, we want green gems. We want as many of them as possible. Yep, more beehives. We're gonna have fun with this. I'm hitting the wall. It's unfortunate, but it happens. The tornado will suck all the bees in there, so I don't have to worry about it. There's one more green gem, that's good. Oops, sorry about that. Alright, so the winged boots from the Ignan Ruins finally come in handy now. Oop, dodge that. Now this one bomb here can be a little bit tricky, so I'm gonna go slow intentionally. Walk on and then back up immediately, as he can very, very easily slide down and blow up in your face for 60 damage. 3, 4. Ah, I didn't hit any of them. Wait, why did I cook the fire crystal? Alright, so remember how fish can hurt? And they don't, and they spawn in numbers. You guys are about to experience this, or at least witness what it's like to deal with these fish. It's not fun. Okay, fish. These green ones move in a completely random pattern. So I don't really know if I'm going to be able to hit them, or they're going to hit me first. Please, thank you. Actually, was that egg toast that got stuck on the wall? Can I grab that? No, the game just doesn't want me to have it. 3, 5. Alright, so bees are shell shroom, and I locked on a little bit. Okay. That's unfortunate. Alright, so these are shell shroom, and they like to hide in their hard iron-clad shells, and they don't take any physical damage when they're hiding in there. So a well-timed attack, interrupting them when they're attacking, can deal damage, or using magic. Okay, so this is the windmill stage, and there's a boulder blocking the exit, and I honestly have no idea how this game works, because we clear the area and then the boulder just moves itself. You'll see what I mean. Okay, so we've got the gems we needed. 3 blue, 3 green. Oh, let's wait for this guy. Alright, more dead angling. 7, 8. Put the wing boots on, and this is the number one reason why we want wing boots. To receive the hidden treasure here. Water that guy. Water this shell. Water the both of those. Oh, skeletons are back. We're gonna take advantage of these skeletons and farm some gems off of them. Okay, they are not being cooperative. Okay, they are completely being uncooperative. Okay, we can work with that. Grab 1, 2, 3. Wait, oh. I picked them up in the wrong order. Good job. That was supposed to be super armor, so that I don't get knocked back from these guys, but I didn't hold the magic button when picking up the second gem. So that was a mistake. No, that still worked out well. Yep, so the developers decided to put enemies on these slopes. And they slide down and hit their spawn circle and can't fall any further. So like I mentioned, it kinda just turns itself on and pushes the boulder. That thing is huge, by the way. We're gonna grab this toast. The music changed, so we're inside this clock tower windmill thing. Those of you who are paying attention, you saw that the windmill was sizable, in a word? Yeah, I'm not gonna argue. This game has already lost sense in what it's doing. Because the interior of this clock tower thing, windmill, it's just... Yeah, it's huge on the inside, and how it was designed is very questionable. Okay, Good, because that would have taken forever to fall. Can I make it this guy too? No, I didn't. So we're kind of at the point where any kind of magical damage will deal more than 20. And that's a pretty large amount of damage to take. There is a shell shroom on the top of this pillar. We're not going after it. So yeah, this windmill is huge and contains some sort of labyrinth inside of it as well. So we de-equipped the winged boots and replaced it with the fire crystal because there's a lot of skeletons to work with. And we're gonna need some sort of magic damage to deal with these skeletons. Okay, we're gonna wait for this guy to float down because we want every gem, please. So, yeah, we're gonna wait for enemies to hit the ground before casting any sort of magic because magic isn't exactly accurate and travels very slow. Perfect. I only needed 3 gems of any kind that wasn't yellow, or that isn't yellow. Move back so I don't get quite explosion. Keep moving along. 1, 2. 1, 2. And we're just jump off this ledge. Alright, so we've encountered a giant red bomb and a giant blue bomb, and now we have a giant green bomb. And no, there's no giant yellow bomb. Oh, there's no... I wanted some super armor, but this game does not want to drop any gems at all. 6, 7, 1, 2... Oh, it didn't want to drop any favorable gems. So we're just going to grab a bunch of them. It doesn't really matter which ones we grab because most of them are just used to explode bombs. We will never kill giant yellow bombs. Never. I kinda wish they had put in yellow bombs, because that would have been interesting to see giant boulders fall from the sky and then we cry because those things have a massive hitbox. We're just about approaching. We're just about finished clearing this area. Yep, this is a pretty long stage, just because it's all. It crosses itself and it goes all over the place. Okay, so this game did not want to give me another yellow gem. That's fine. Wait for this section to load. This is the only time in the game that you will ever cease, or you'll ever experience ice physics on snow. And there is an item in this game that does prevent you from sliding. So I'm not sure what the developers were thinking at that time. And yeah, Elmo once again decides to be a jerk. Oh, I hope you guys enjoy frame loss. 44 frames. Yeah, we're having fun with frames here. Chibi Run? When is Chibi's Run? One necessary thing. Save, and we're gonna do a quick save and quit. We're gonna skip about 20 seconds worth of cutscenes and dialogue. And we went straight to the Sealed Palace. Alright, game, work with me here. Come on, please, green gems. I need as many of them as possible. Okay, that'll do. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's okay if I take some damage. Yes, I just needed 6 green gems to work with. And now we can go heal up. I need to look at there's 2 over there. 2, 3. 3 green gems. 1, 2, 3, 4. Super armor. And I want blue gem. 2 reds. And we're gonna hope another blue gem spawns. And not on this stage. One, two, three. 3 bombs exploded. If we went too far forward, the bombs would have de-rendered, and we would have had to go on back and re-render them to fall off the stage. Stage. This final stage here has eye bath that deal 40 damage, and we only have 100 health, so we're gonna play it real careful. 1, 2, 3. Once again, the tornado skill comes in handy, or the tornado spell comes in handy, and gathers up all those fish for us. 2, 3. We're gonna go and clear this center knight first, and those are, just to make things clear, those are hedgehogs. No, they're porcupines. Actually, they're whatever they want you to be. They're whatever they want to be. Game? Alright, we're gonna go and farm some gems off of them. Please drop gems that are useful. So both of those were low damage rolls, so we gotta wait for this guy. Damn. We're trying to take the least amount of damage as possible. Oh, thank you for following. Bad RNG. Didn't give me any gems, and I need the red gem for later. Okay, this game really doesn't want me to run today, or generally have good luck on this marathon. Quick menuing again. Oh, now it gives me red gems. Okay, you know, after all of them dropped. Okay, okay. Oh, don't tell me it despawned the yellow gem. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. We're just going to have to play this a little bit safer. Only hit them once, I don't want to have them explode and deal 40 damage. There it is. Okay, now we can have fun. 2, 3. 2 damage. 25 damage. 23 damage. Alright, so we do take reduced damage, but they are still dealing double digits. And taking a lot of double digits hits are bad. Even though these little blue slimes, or the baby slimes, are spawns, we still need to defeat them in order to clear the area. And the game was nice and it gave us everything we need, but where is the health drops? There should have been 3. There's the other one. Maximum health is preferred. I mean, they already give you a ton of health anyways. Might as well grab all of it. So leaving the area and then coming back skips a 10 to 12 second cutscene, and then we're just gonna say screw it and just leave again, because, you know, we have problems. Here we go. So by approaching this door when it's open and then leaving, it's supposed to represent that we're cowardice. And then it gives us these rocket gloves. So for the first time ever, we meet the monk. And he's an NPC way in the back of town that gives you hints at the cost of your maximum life. We don't need him. Two, three, four. I'm gonna wait for gems to drop so I know where they're dropping. Pretty low damage rolls. I didn't actually want to start magic, so I'm gonna drop these quickly. And I do not want them to grab. Okay, no, it spawned out that one, so we're good. Now I want to use it. Because there's 2 of them, and I don't want to be taking twice the damage. Gonna play it a little bit safe and get our gems. Oh. Alright, now we wait for gem RNG to give us what we want. Yep. This is just a waiting game because that silhouette has 1 HP. Alright, we're looking for another set of... Oh, that's fire. Alright, not too bad. The AI didn't go crazy and grab every single gem in the field. And this is the Archdevil. The evil protagonist that's been turning people into fairies. And here is Ira, who has superpowers. I don't know. And we turn up and we find out that Elma is a fairy. The story is just all over the place. 1, 2, 3. 3, 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna follow this for a little bit. And that saves us a couple of frames because the bombs dealt damage to the boss. And now we're on to the part that everyone hates. I'm gonna wear the shield. So, we're trying to throw energy at this boss to deal damage, but Elma wasn't very helpful because she's not blood related. So our bond, the bond between human and fairy, wasn't strong enough. And now we're playing a beta version of Toho. So we're gonna be doing this for the next 2 minutes. And we're trying to do critical manipulations here by attacking by performing a jump attack when the projectile has been launched. We'll add the critical multiplier onto it. So we're just gonna be jumping around, hitting nothing for the next little while. Welcome back. Lasers? Okay, wasn't sure where those lasers were going. And I don't have any sort of magic resistance, so that would have easily dealt 20 to 30 damage. Oops. Oh, no one saw that. Okay, this game, this boss does not want me to have fun. Yep, so we're gonna probably be doing this for the next 30 seconds. I do hope everyone is enjoying the marathon. Alright, so the boss is finally over, and now we skip all this text to find out that the boss is weakened, and now we can finally deliver the final blow. And we throw our sister. Good job. Alright, Elise is dead. No, at least Shantae's dead. Time is coming up shortly. It's when Finn appears in the bottom right hand corner.
Just call it up.
Yeah, time.
It's 59:02.
Yay! Alright, that's it. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for the run, good sir. Yeah. It was pretty interesting. IMO, of course.
Oh, yeah, thank you. and I thank you for having me run this morning. I'm clearly not in it today.
It's all good, man. It's early.
It is early.
All right, stream next up. Got Mirror's Edge Catalyst. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.